Hi, this is Dr. Graves from the CSUN Geography Department and geographyplanet.org. This video tutorial is designed to help students, particularly those in Los Angeles, find local data. We oftentimes look for data at the federal or the state level, but the LA City and LA County both have impressive data portals. So let's take a look at a handful of the things that I find valuable. The first of these is, in these times, is the LA County Health Department has COVID data that you can download and manipulate for your own purposes, your own research purposes. By the way, the Los Angeles Times also has a similar data portal on their GitHub. That's G-I-T-H-U-B, and it can be downloaded. So that's the LA County Department of Public Health. I also value their listing of restaurants, by the way, as well, because I do some research into fast food access. The County of Los Angeles has this site as well, that is under government and public information and records. And the LA County Open Data is the, for my money, the best of these sites. So I'm going to open it up here. And there are data windows to a number of concerns. The property and planning one is interesting, as is the health and homeless data. You may find those useful. The LA County GIS webpage, Enterprise GIS, also has lots of data that you can download in a variety of formats. If you're a geographer and you have some experience with GIS, this is really outstanding to get the base map layers, data on environmental conditions. They have a nice addressing tool that it will allow you to convert county addresses to a point map and then demographic data. For the purpose of this assignment, I wanted to show you how to go find the City of Los Angeles data portal. It's the way you would find, I presume, the County of Los Angeles data portal as well. It's just a Google search, and it's this open data initiative that you would want to click on. It brings you here. There's some of the things that they sort of give you, black-owned businesses, high risk for COVID, that sort of stuff. And these are stories, and they have within many of them links. But the data catalog itself is where they take you. So if we show that here and then switch to most accessed, you find some of the data that is of interest to lots of people. Building permit data, I've been looking at it as part of a study on homelessness. Listing of active businesses, I'm generally unimpressed with that data, and I've used it several times. Foreclosure, I've had students do that. But what we're going to do today is to take a look at the arrest data from 2010 to 2019. So I'm going to click on that. And once you click on that, then this window appears. This is a rather large data set, and you may find that the number of rows here at 1.32 million is too much for your software. And so what we're going to do is we're going to click on view data, but then we're going to filter it down. And what we'll do is just take a single year. So the arrest data runs from 2010 to 2019. So we're going to ask a filter on that. And let's just do, for example, maybe 1 year, or maybe we'll do, let's do 5 years, and let's do the arrest date. And ask to get us arrests between two dates. And so let's do between I'm gonna click here 2020, but what we want to do is say 2015 and January 1st, 2021, but let's just make that December 31st, New Year's Eve 2020. So we'll have 5 years of data, and that now represents only 500,000 or 500,000, 420,000 rows of data, which Excel will handle. If it is still too large, we could add a new filter condition later and say, let's just get it from the reporting district or these charge codes, different kinds of arrests, that kind of thing. So this is just the arrest data. It has some latitude and longitude coordinates there, which are generally going to be generalized to the block level or intersection, which is somewhat useful but also somewhat misleading. So once we have that, click on export, and a CSV for Excel is an outstanding way to do it. If you want to map this data instead, and you're not a GIS, or even if you are a GIS expert, notice that KML, shapefile, and GeoJSON are also download options. But for the purpose of this tutorial, we're going to go with CSV, that's comma separated values for Excel. Click it once. Give it a name, and so this is LAPD, and it is the arrest data for 2015 to 2020, and click Save. And it's downloading in the lower right-hand corner. I'm using Google Chrome, which means the downloads appear here, but if you're using Microsoft browser, Firefox, or an Apple browser, it may appear elsewhere. So once I have this, I'm going to double click and the file will open momentarily. And there it is. And what we're going to do with this is instantly modify it in a pivot table, which will allow us to do some a variety of things. So go ahead and click Insert Pivot Table and okay. Now that it's in a pivot table, we can begin to populate a new table that allows us to do a number of quick analysis on it. I'm going to put area name down here, which are the various LAPD divisions. And then we could put something like charge group description over here in the columns, and then that has all of the various kinds of crimes that people get arrested for, and then grab that once again, charge group description, and drop it into values, which gives us a count of each of those crimes by geography, by division. And from here, we can do a number of analyses on this data. So that ends this tutorial on downloading some crime data from a local data source.